And then Mummy said, she said, that's what makes your cheeks pink, Nigel. Oh, I was a beautiful baby, Eugene. Well, you've seen all the pictures. Which one was your favorite? Please tell me. You're right, they're all delicious. Carey, I'd like you to meet my new best friend. This is Eugene.
Eugene, I know him, sir. He's worked on his shoes for years.
Yes, yes, but I never really got to know him. He's such a bright fellow, not just another yes man. Right, Eugene? You keep me honest. Tell me, do you want to hit the strip clubs by the airport this evening? Oh, I know that smile, you old dog. You're ready to go right now, aren't you? You push all my naughty buttons. All right, I'll go and get my coat, but don't talk about me while I'm gone.
What's with the silent act?
Listen, Carey, I've paid attention around here. People who shoot off their mouths never get ahead.
That's ridiculous. Look at me. Go on.
If you don't say anything, you never say the wrong thing.
Well, maybe that's true for the short run, but I'm in it for the long run. I believe in working hard, keeping your nose to the grindstone, maybe...
Oh, stop your jabbering, Carey. Is he bothering you, Eugene?
Oh, won't rat out a fellow employee, eh?
God, I love this man! Anyway, who says you can't have ice cream for breakfast? Certainly not you. I asked you many times. You're as naughty as I am, aren't you?
Yes, you are.
Here's Anderson's file.
Who's Anderson?
He's those feet dangling out of your rear end.
Eugene. Well, Eugene Anderson, you are formally promoted to manager of the men's department. Here's your pass to the executive parking lot. We don't have a space for you yet, but you can use Carey's.
What?
Thank you.
What was that? Thank you. Was that sarcasm?
No, sir.
No, sir. I don't think I like your tone, Anderson. Success has turned you ugly. Don't call me.
Why did I talk?
What? Why did I talk?
I don't like him anymore.
Eugene. I just came by to apologize for what I said before. I was totally out of line. I was having a bad day. I just hope you'll come back to work. Really, I mean it. Truth is, you're the only one who ever really understood me. Please come back, pal. Okay. Okay! That's big of you. Forget it! Don't do me any favors. In fact, you're fired!
Jeez, what's his problem?
Beats me.
What the hell's that supposed to mean?
Get out of my bar!
Wow, a rose. Nice. It looks like someone has a secret admirer.
Wow, I haven't had a secret admirer since... Wow, a secret admirer.
So, Drew, I hear that you swore off women a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, store therapist talked me into it. Yeah, I took some time off to find the real me, and I felt better.
Good for you. I found the real me in the Navy.
Hold on. Every time they hear the bell ring, the actor has to come up with a new line.
I found the real me when I was a body double on the movie Touched by a Hell's Angel. I found the real me when I was on that rafting trip in the Ozarks.
Hey, bro. Hey, guys. Hey, Eugene, you seen Kate here yet?
No.
No!
Lewis, I need to talk to you.
Boy, if it weren't for this apple brown Betty I found out by the garbage, this would be Drew's worst party ever.
I don't know. He had a pretty bad one about 5 years ago.
Hold on. Let's play conducted story. Whoever I point to has to keep the story going, right where it left off. This story is about a retirement party for the bomb squad.
It was a long ticking, but the time to say goodbye to Stumpy and the guys.
Stumpy was the squad leader. He taught us all how to disarm all the bombs.
They were all shaky, 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 shaky.
St- Stumpy started spinning on his stump and entertaining us all that night.
But then Lefty came along, and man, was that guy funny.
Yeah, Lefty was Stumpy's brother. They used to be in the Boy Scouts.
And in the Navy, where they used to stump around wearing...
Hey, wait a second, guys, there's Kate.
Oh. Oh.
Okay, she's gonna lead me right to him.
All right. Come on, men. Let's show these women we can be as wild and crazy as they are.
Yeah!
Let's put on a talent show.
Oh, come on.
Anybody? Anybody?
I'm not afraid to shine. This song goes out to a very special someone. I think you know who you are. You are so beautiful to me. You are
oh,
so beautiful.
Wayne's not
to
the guy.
Me.
Eugene's the guy Kate's in love
can't
with.
You
are you sure?
Singing right at
you're
her.
Everything I
can't even tell how I feel to her face. He's doing it in front of all
you're
these people.
Everything I need.
And he's friendly, too.
You are so beautiful to me.
Oh, wonderful.
So, Drew, you like the song?
It was beautiful. Listen, Eugene, you're a nice guy, so I'm going to be honest with you. I know we're both after the same thing, but you have to believe me when I tell you, I want it so much more than you do.
I don't think that's possible.
All right, let's try that kiss one more time. But this time, you're Siegfried and Roy.
No!
All right, you're Madeline Albright and a rabid monkey. You're Sybil Shepherd and a German Shepherd.
Well, the good news is Eugene's not the guy that, that's in love with Kate. And also, Eugene told me that my butt's as cute as a cupcake.
Oh. Hey, Kate's all alone. Now's your chance. Go talk to her.
Haven't you been paying attention? All day I've been acting like a jealous junior high kid. I'm not ready for a serious adult relationship right now. Mm. Well, better tell Eugene it's all over between us.
Yeah. Eugene just told me I got a butt like a cupcake.
That bitch! Now we need that money. I'm out of a job. I'm broke.
Then you shouldn't have quit.
I didn't quit. I was fired.
Well, that's not what the paperwork said. Maybe you should talk to the assistant director of personnel.
I was the assistant director of personnel.
Then you shouldn't have quit.
I didn't quit. I was fired.
Well, there must be a mistake in the paperwork. Why don't you talk to the assistant director of personnel?
I was the assistant director of personnel.
Then you shouldn't have quit.
I didn't quit. I was fucked. Oh, I give up.
Ah, so you did quit. Benefits denied. And that's our little show. Thank you very much. Eugene, you didn't clap. Why not?
Because I think what you did to Drew was cruel.
Really? Well, now you're going to think this is very, very cruel. You're fired, too. And, everyone, Eugene's internet name is Mr. Lovely Cheeks. Eugene's internet name is Mr. Fabulous Bottom Trouser Man. Yes, I know.
Ah, Mr. Fabulous Bottom Trouser Man, at last we meet.
Now what am I going to do?
Oh, I'm so sorry. This is all my fault. Listen, I know a lot of people could use a CPA like you. I'll put in a couple of calls and get you an interview.
Oh, thanks, Drew. Gee, I wish there was a way to repay you. Now, you're definitely not gay, huh? Because I could really rock your world.
Believe me, Eugene, if there was a way I could get turned on by a lumpy middle-aged man, I would be flipping you like a pancake. If there was a way I could get turned on by Canadians, I'd have moved there by now.
I'd show you my great white north.
Oh.
Hey, how about if I just give you 10% of my first month's salary, like I would any employment agency?
All right. Oh, wait a second. I could start my own employment agency. I put people in jobs all the time. Thanks a lot, Eugene.
It must be jam, because jelly don't shake like that.
So, Mr. Anderson, can you explain this 2-year gap in your work history?
I wish I could. I was drunk and living with a bullfighter in Mexico.
No, Eugene. In an interview, you're supposed to accentuate the positive instead of the negative. So you weren't a drunk living with a bullfighter in Mexico. You were bending over backwards to open up relations down south. You weren't drunk living with a bullfighter in Mexico. You were with me last Saturday. Shh. Now, give me another negative about yourself.
Well, I watch soaps while I make long-distance phone calls on the company dime.
No, so you, my friend, are a multitasker. Excuse me.
Oh, you know what? I once ran over someone and kept on going.
No, no, no. You don't let obstacles get in your way. Now get out of here. Carey Employment Agency. Oh! Carey must be on line one. Yeah. Carey Employment Agency.